and welcome to Signature TV News Highlights for this Tuesday. I am Damilola Abudu. The Center for Disease Control, NCDC, has said that Nigeria is reaching a critical level where hospitals can no longer cope with more serious COVID-19 cases. In a tweet on Monday, the NCDC Director General, Dr. Chikwe Iyekwazu, said health workers would be forced to make tough decisions, calling for the protection of vulnerable citizens amid the rising cases of the virus. The NCDC boss said the number of coronavirus cases reported in the country had been on the rise in the last 4 weeks. According to Iyekwazu, Nigerians must note that 100,000 persons that contracted COVID-19 in the last 11 months were not just figures, but persons. The Borno State Governor, David Umahi, has ordered fumigation of public institutions in the state to contain the spread of COVID-19 pandemic. This is contained in a statement by the state's Commissioner for Health, Dr. Daniel Hiezurike, on Tuesday in Abakaliki. Hiezurike said the fumigation will last for 3 days, commence on January 13th and end on January 15th. He named some of the places to be fumigated to include old and new government house, Executive Council Chambers, Judiciary Premises, Centenary City Secretariat, Security Agency's Quarters, Legislative Premises, and Markets. Meanwhile, the Commissioner said that it was an offence for private hospitals to carry out tests for COVID-19 or treat COVID-19 patients in the state, as the government has enough facilities to offer such services for free. The Academic Staff Union of Universities, ASU, on Tuesday insisted Nigerian universities are not ready to reopen in the middle of a second wave of the coronavirus pandemic. The National Universities Commission had earlier directed universities to resume academic activities on January 18th, but ASU is asking the federal government to review the decision as more COVID-19 cases continue to be reported across the country. ASU recently called off a 10-month strike over demands related to salary structure and government support for universities. The Abia State Governor, Okezie Ikpazu, has reacted to the controversy trailing the recently conducted election of Ohanaeze Ndigbo. Ikpazu, who spoke from Umuahia with newsmen on Monday, condemned the existence of fractional leadership of the Igbo Apex Socio-Cultural Organization. The Abia Governor asked the Igbo people to drum support for the newly elected President General of the Ohanaeze Ndigbo, noting that the move would lead to development of the Southeast region. Speaking further, Governor Ikpazu said the emergence of Professor Obiozo is linked to the survival of the Igbos. Manchester United will face Liverpool in the blockbuster tie of the FA Cup fourth round, while League Two, Cheltenham hosts Manchester United. Liverpool and United will clash for two consecutive weekends, with the top two also facing off in the Premier League on Sunday. That's the Signature TV News highlights. For details, visit www.signaturetv.org. On behalf of my producer, Obomanu Marvelous, thanks for watching. I am Damilola Abudu.